New Age Business Breakfast in Mmabatho with the Premier of the Northwest Province, Supra, Mahumapelo. They're discussing the rebranding and the renewal of the province. It's over to you.
Indeed, Rala Mohela Lotle Kwano Ko Province in Yabugoni Bupirima, we're welcoming you all live right here at Mafikeng. The province is now Bukoni Bupirima, officially it would appear. And we're going to unpack what the Premier, Re Supra Mahumapelo, presented as his State of the Province address a week or so ago, last week, so to say. And indeed, we welcoming you to this business breakfast. Our hashtag, if you would like to participate, and would urge you indeed to participate, is hashtag TNA Biz Brief. Hashtag TNA Biz Brief. That is how you will be able to participate on social media and perhaps ask your questions or comments, anything that you'd like to say in as far as the state of this province is concerned, Bukoni Bupirima. Let me welcome on my panel the Premier, indeed, of the province of Rapremiaki, Rako Bukoni Bupirima, Hotsako Northwest.
Remo Bukoni Bupirima, it's Katamala.
Let me welcome.
Northwest Castana Gibugon Wupiri.
Right.
Yes.
Kohamohit.
Ralebo.
MEC for Finance, Economy and Enterprise Development, Honorable Wendy. Joy Nelson, you also joining us. We welcome you as well.
Thank you. Good morning, Mpho, and good morning to our viewers and to our guests this morning.
Okay, and obviously our MEC for Tourism, Med Desbo Mohono, Rahmahla. Okay, that is it. Those are our guests for today. And indeed, my name is Mpho Tsedu. I'm standing in for Pitandoro, and we welcome you to this TNA Business Breakfast. Premier, quite a speech you presented last week. Let us just briefly recap on some of the highlights of that presentation that you made.
Well, in that speech, Mpho, and the viewers at home, we were reminding our people that we have a legacy of over 340 years that we have to deal with here in South Africa, and that we have been in government for just about 21 years. But in the same context, we were also bringing to the attention of our people that we are implementing as provinces our programs in the context of the National Development Plan. But we also unpack into the people of Bukoni Bupirima the fact that as the FIFA administration, our decision was that we will approach the National Development Plan in the context of the necessary rebranding, repositioning, and renewal of the province. Linked to that, we agreed that concretely as we implement the National Development Plan, we will adopt five concretes in as far as addressing the challenges that we face are concerned. Those five concretes are ACT, which is the agriculture, culture, and tourism. The second one is VTSD, which is the villages, the townships, and the small dorpies. The third one is RHR, which is the reconciliation, healing, and renewal. The fourth one, it is some work, some track, and the fifth one is the program of Tsetsokotsane.
Which is your favorite, by the way.
Yes, it is my favorite. Because it's about people, putting people at the center of everything that we do.
Okay, Premier, I listened and I watched that presentation. And I couldn't help but ask myself, what kind of a politician is this one who is admitting to challenges? Politicians do not generally just admit that we have failed here or we have challenges here and there. Let's just talk about that.
Look, in the African National Congress, our belief is that we must be candid with our people. We must be honest to the masses of our people. Where we have made progress, we must be able to say we have made progress. Where we have made strides, we must also acknowledge and communicate them with the necessary decisiveness. But at the same time, where we have made mistakes, where we are facing challenges, we must acknowledge and say to our masses of our people, in the course of the execution of the program to better your lives, working with yourselves, we've committed the following mistakes. They were not deliberate, but also the fact that we have a plan to overcome the mistakes and the challenges that we are facing. Our philosophy also is that challenges are necessary platforms for success. You can only succeed in life if you come across challenges, and if you use those challenges as stepping stones for you to make more advancements in advancing the betterment of the lives of our people, it will not help. And we say this to the councillors at all times, members of parliament, members of the legislature. Mm-hmm. On a regular basis, we must make sure that we convene meetings of our communities and communicate in clear, simple terms our successes, the challenges that we face. Where we made failures, we must also communicate that to our people, so that our people can realize that we are honest with them, we are transparent, and we respect them. As soon as we start cutting corners and not communicating the truth to our masses, they will lose faith in us and support.
MEC Nelson, you Mmabatho, you deal with the finances. The Premier presented that one of the challenges that the province faced was the fruitless and wasteful expenditure of over a period of 20 years, I must emphasize, 10.7 billion rand without consequences. Can we safely say that there are going to be consequences for those who squander public funds?
Oh, absolutely, Mpho. I think Premier has raised that in his speech as well. He has been raising it regularly. We have been discussing it, and we have really now taken the stance where we're saying fruitless, wasteful expenditure, irregular expenditure is unacceptable, and we are going to be tying audit action plans to HODs, to municipal managers, to everyone's performance contracts. To ensure that we have consequence management. I think gone are the days where we look at problems and don't do anything about those problems. I think this fifth administration is very serious. It is really very serious about service delivery. It is very serious about ensuring that we use the resources, let's say the very scarce resources that we have, to its optimal benefit. We have to ensure that we use it in a manner which where we can track the rand, where we know where money is going to. And so it's our responsibility, I think, at the end of the day, to ensure that we do not have these types of irregular, fruitless and wasteful expenditure. So definitely there's going to be consequence management. It's out there, everyone knows that. And we really are going to be sticking to this.
Where was money lost, though? Where is it getting lost? At local government, provincial?
Well, it's across the board. What we're finding is there are systems in place. There are procedures that need to be followed. Now, in many instances, we have money spent, but it's not spent according to the guidelines that there are. It is not spent within the framework, the legislative framework that is there. And that then gives rise to irregular expenditure. It may not be that the money has been spent incorrectly, but the process that needed to be followed was incorrect. So we have lots of that types of situation. It still will result in consequence management. Okay. It is the process. We need to ensure that the processes that are in place, that these processes are followed and that it's done correctly.
So in the event, let me see, that those processes are not followed, can we expect some tough action, and what is it?
Yes, well, there's definitely going to be action. People need to be held accountable. Mm-hmm. We are not working with our own budgets, with our own monies. We are working with taxpayers' monies, and we need to be accountable. So people will be charged, and they will be dealt with when they do not comply.
Three things, Mpho. Just in addition, we have already had a meeting with the Auditor General. and agreed with the Auditor General that we are going to work very hard to wipe out all this unaccountability that goes with this irregular, fruitless, and wasteful expenditure. So there's an action plan agreed by the executive and communicated to the to the Auditor General. Secondly, we have agreed as the executive that we are putting what we call audit action management committee, which is going to be dealing with issues of consequence management. And on a regular basis, monthly to be specific, they will be reporting to the executive so that we can take some tough action. Pop a hand dance.
Okay. I mean, see, Desbo, let me just bring you in here. We were confused. Are we going to Northwest? Are we going to Bukoni Buperima? What is it?
Indeed, the Premier have explained, Mpho, that Northwest in Setswana is Bukoni Buperima. Mm. When we were born, estimately 2 years ago, you know, as politicians, our responsibility after we are being deployed is to carry the mandate given to us. And the Premier will just pronounce policy, and department must ensure that the policy pronounced by the Premier is being carried. The Premier gave us a mandate, go and establish a department called tourism and make sure that it contribute to the economic growth of the province. And he came up with another policy pronouncement of 5 concrete that he has explained on. And the first one is act, of which I fall within that act. Now what happened is that we sat down at the department, we realized on our own we won't make it. And the Premier saying we must contribute to the economic growth. How can we do it? We then realized that we can't do anything without the people. We need to involve them. Then as a department, we came up with a program of ensuring that we call Mahota. We call everybody within the industry. Mm. But what is it that we can do to attract people? We came up with a brand. And that brand says, calling people to come to the Northwest. And it's a brand that is flourishing in the country, in the continent, and all over the world. Because people were interested, what is this thing, Ariembukoni Bupirim? Mm-hmm. We are simply saying, come to the Northwest. It's a different province, and there is a lot that you can enjoy in that particular province that you don't know about. There is a lot more that people don't know, even the people that stay in the Northwest. What is the potential that this province have? And I'm challenging the citizens of this province and of this country to watch the space and follow us every day and check the trend of our growth within the province and see how tourism is making sure that together with agriculture, together with culture, making sure that people make Northwest Hota Bukoni Buphirima a destination of choice.
You know, let me see. The other thing when it comes to tourism is that are you encouraging locals, the people of Northwest or Baahi, Bukoni Buphirima, to visit their own province domestically?
You know, one of the concrete is Tsitsukutsani. Mm. And we also, Premier have also pronounced villages, township, and small dorobi.
Yes.
When we talk to our people, we realize that our people don't even know their backyard. Now, what we are doing as tourism, we are going to our people to show them what their province is having. Mm. For an example, I wonder if Mpho, you know a place called Bray. When you are in Bray, we use the network of Botswana. You are just next to the Namibia border. Mm. We are giving life to that area. It's fall under Kagisano Molopo. It fall under Kagisano Molopo municipality. We are having a beautiful event there. And this year we want to make it a bomb, the Bray July, where the jockey of the horses are the farm workers. This year, Mpho, we are sleeping in the tent in Bray. There's no accommodation. And sleeping in a tent is part of tourism. And Northwest is one of the rural provinces. We want people to experience the nature in Northwest. Also myself, I sleep in the tent.
But MEC, it means you must then take some of these functions and events away from Sun City, Mmabatho, Rustenburg to those dorpies.
No ways. No ways. We've got a balance act. Okay. The Premier said we must take the services to our people in our, because they were disadvantaged for a long time. By the way, Mpho, Sun City is in a village called Liedach. It's not in a township. There is no way you can take away the events that are taking place in Sun City. What we are doing as tourism, we are not competing in the province. We look at each and every district. What is this district specializing on? And Mpho, you can't just come from Limpopo and say, I'm visiting Bukoni Buphirima. What are you going to do there? There must be a reason to come to Bukoni Bophirima. And the hospitality that we'll provide to you in this province will ensure that we attract people to come here. One of our responsibilities as tourism is to attract investors. We don't want people to come here and sleep for a day or two. We want people to spend a week here. Among other engagement that we did with the Premier and the stakeholders is after opening our airport, we want to make sure that we have airlines that come straight from the BRICS countries, come down to us and enjoy with us what is it that we have. If there was time, I will take you through each and every district. What is it that you can get in that particular district? And it's different from each other. What you get in Dr. KK is not what you get in Dr. Ruth. What you get in here in Akamudirumlem is not what you get in Bujanal.
Okay, let me see. Hold it there. I want us to take a quick break. We still have time. Premier, we're going to talk about a lot of things, including the Gupta family. For now, though, we're going to take a quick break. When we return, we'll continue with this special broadcast coming to you live from Bukoni Bophirima in Mafikeng. And please do indeed join us and contribute the hashtag TNA BizBrief. And this is the TNA BizBrief live from Mafikeng.
When pregnant with her first daughter, Relebogile knew that she wanted her daughter not to experience any identity issues. This is when she decided to look for toys that resembled black as beautiful.
I think for me, it was also just to get our girls to have some sense of identity somewhere, some sense of belonging.
I grew up having black and white dolls, and going to a multiracial school, I did not really see color. So for me, it's this thing of, she should actually know what her true identity is.
Join your host, Buleng Mulebadze, on Bophelong every Friday at 17:30. Children's rights and health are a priority in the journey of good health.
All children should have access to adequate health care. Right. Not only curative, but preventative as well.
How to identify ADHD on children.
ADHD is a childhood disorder which manifests with the symptoms of hyperactivity, impulsivity, and or inattention.
Is breastfeeding still a vital nutrition to babies even today?
Breastfeeding for the first 6 months of life is absolutely crucial.
Catch Health Talk with Dr. Sello Mutawung every Saturday from 9 till 10 a.m.
A very good afternoon. You're watching the Midday Report.
Lunchtime news amplified.
But for now, this is what they call home. Their hope to shift to higher ground seems to be against the tide.
Midday Report provides you with more than just news stories.
I just want Port Elizabeth to know that they own a world-class theatre.
Good afternoon, you're with the news at 1 in the headlines.
Very good afternoon to you. This is News Live. I'm Natasha Thorpe. Let's take a quick look at what's coming up in your headlines.
Good afternoon and welcome to Airview from the House.
For all things news, tune in to Midday Report weekdays at 12 noon only on the SABC News Channel.
Welcome back to this special broadcast, and like I said, we're coming to you live from Mafikeng, Bukoni Bophirima, that is the name of the province now, and I'm with the, or rather in Mahikeng, the Premier has just corrected me, I still regard the F's as F's, no, Mahikeng. Let me welcome you once again. This is the SABC TNA Business Breakfast with the Premier of Bukoni Bophirima, Re Supra Mahumapelo, and our MECs here. Premier, let's quickly, and we'll have enough time to brag, so to say.
Okay.
But firstly, coming to Mahigeng,
yes.
I don't know whether I used Tselatsamakhotlo or, you know, the wrong roads, but the road that I used wasn't very pleasant to drive on.
From Lichtenburg. That's the road you may have used from Lichtenburg. The the road from Lichtenburg up to when you have just passed it to say.
Yes.
It's okay because it was done about 2.5 years ago. We have taken a decision that 20 kilometers towards Mahike, which is the capital city, from this financial year, we are going to be expanding that road. We are also going to be expanding the road as we enter Mahikeng from Freiburg. 15, 20 kilometers is going to be expanded because the one from Botswana is already expanded. The one from Zeerust is still okay. So the two, we need to sort them out because they are not projecting a good image about us as the capital. So ourselves working together with the Mahikeng municipality, we have agreed that we need to attend to that road. So the Department of Public Works and Roads will be very soon be attending to that particular road. That's why we are going to request people who are now constructing houses next to the road at Roykhorond,
yes,
to engage them because they are building their houses closer to the road. They didn't know that we are going to expand the road, but we have spoken to Public Works and the municipality, so they're engaging them. So it will be fine by the end of the financial year.
And somebody may be watching, MEC mentioned a village which I do not know, but I also know there's a village called Tipitsidi Tsuleja.
Yes.
Well, somebody may be watching us from Tipitsidi Tsuleja and saying, Nahari Babuakang, Hakena Mitsi, Hakena Kwere Kwere. What are they talking about?
As part of the VTSD, villages, townships, and small dorpies, and I'm happy our traditional leaders are here because we have met with them and we have agreed on the way forward. We have agreed that for the first time in the history of this province, we are going to target all the 767 villages in the province as part of VTSD. We'll be targeting the 73 townships and the 23 small dorpies. There's a team which we have set up. It started doing work in February. That team is in all the villages to make sure that by the end of June, we have got village development plans. It means every village, as part of the national development plan, will have a village development plan.
Oh,
how did you go? Yes, how did you go? How did you go? You'll be knowing what is it that government is going to do, national, provincial, district, local, and the traditional leadership. This financial year, the next financial year, there'll be booklets which we are going to develop, which every household will have. So there'll be nobody who will go to a village, go to a family and say to them, you are not very sure of what government will be doing this year. We wanted to be thorough. We are working with States SA to do that particular matter. The other decision we have taken is that this financial year, 60 to 70% of government spending will go to the villages, the townships, and the small dorpies. The MEC for Finance here knows very well. We are now changing the procedures that for many years, our people in the villages have been put in the periphery. Time has come now for us to put them at the center. Because we all move from the villages to the bigger cities.
Yeah.
And we put pressure on the bigger cities. We affect planning in the bigger cities. So we want to make our villages more fashionable going forward as the province. Yesterday, we were in a meeting with economic development, and we're discussing some of the industrial development initiatives which must accompany every village going forward.
Okay. Now, let me see. He's putting painting a very good picture. Is there money to fund all this?
Well, the marching orders have been given, Mpho, and that's very clear. I think what we need to be saying is, we need to do it, we can't do it all on our own. And I think the Premier spoke about the five concretes, and one of the concretes is some trek, some werk.
Yes.
And that means that we need to partner. Government cannot do everything on its own. We have the NWDC, it is our investment wing. We are using it to drive the economy. And the NWDC needs to work, it needs to create partnerships. So whatever we're doing, the vision that we have and the programs that have been raised by the Premier, we are going to be calling on investors to come in and invest and to help us. One of the things, one of the partnerships that I need to speak about, which I think we are very, very excited about, is our relationship with NAFCOC. We have, the Premier has indicated, VTSD is the way we're going, and we need to build the economies in small dorpies. We have just worked with NAFCOC, and we are looking at putting up, I won't say we are looking at, we have agreed that we will be putting up four massive warehouses, one in each of the districts. And that would be solely to drive the economy within our villages and our townships. It will be addressing the tuck shop economy, the salon economy. To put our tuck shops out there again so that they can become competitive and that they can create, you know, get the economy going in their communities again. So if there is money, we're saying we have cut, we have looked at our own budget. We have said, what are the crucial things? What are the things that we can cut for now? What are the things that we can postpone so that we can take all savings and push this to driving the ACT? ACT is crucial for us. That is the route that we are going. And we are saying we need to forge partnerships and we need to take hands with the private sector so that we can build the economy together.
Just to strengthen what the MEC is saying.
Yes.
When you add up the municipal grant, the provincial equitable share, the RDP houses that we are going to be building this year, and some infrastructure-related developments around water, the totality of the amount there is about 19 billion rand.
Okay.
And we have agreed as the province and engaged national that we are going to be spreading the 19 billion rand across the 767 villages. Before, what will happen in the province is that there will be over-concentration of RDP houses in the townships which are adjacent to the bigger cities. So we are now going to be starting with the poorest village and do the allocation to the villages. They'll then be followed by the townships and the small dorpies as part of making sure that we inject some economic activity in our villages. So I just thought that I need to add to what the MEC was saying about the rents and cents that we are having at our disposal. But in addition also, in the State of the Province address, we have announced that the money that we use for rental and leases of government buildings,
yes,
we are now going to be using that money to build our own buildings as government. So for the next 4 to 5 years, there's going to be a rollout of government buildings in the villages, the townships, and the small dorp using the same money. They must go to the villages.
Because I'm serious. There's a lot of businesses that are thriving because they are renting buildings to government.
In business, they say when other people see a forest, you must see trees. So if you are a sharp entrepreneur, you should be realizing that Bokoni Bophirima is now talking about villages, townships, and small dorpies. It means I must migrate my investments and my intentions in as far as business is concerned to the villages. If you want to build a mansion, go and build it. Go visit this villager.
Okay. Let me see. I've just referred to, you know, your tenderpreneurs here. They fly high. Are they able to land here in Bokoni Bophirima?
Yes.
You know, Mkoni, I want you to learn something. Having a lot of money doesn't mean that you can do the best.
Yeah.
Proper planning. I've learned a lot in the few years that I've stayed in government. Proper planning will ensure that what you want to do, you'll definitely achieve. But without planning, you will never achieve. You can have billions and billions. You must remember that, by the way, Northwest is one of the least allocated provinces. The share of the cake that we get is very little. And the Premier is fighting every day that we can't be producing minerals and we are unable to tap into them. That is why in the speech of the Premier on Friday, he insisted that we are going to ensure that the SEZ, where we look at the value chain of our minerals, because by the way, we are not only producing platinum, we are producing a lot. Now, let me tell you, in terms of ACT, by the way, our traditional leaders are part of us in ACT. In culture, we've got traditional affairs. And what you don't know, Mpho, more often, my activities are supported, not only physical support, even financially, by traditional leaders. Now, when you go to traditional leaders, it says you're going to a village. And our entrepreneurs in the village, they are enjoying the fruit that they never enjoyed before. They were only enjoyed by those people who have to migrate to the towns and township so that they can access the funding of the business that are there. But because now, at the Northwest Province, we have taken a step back and say we have missed it somewhere. We went to the crossroad and realized we have missed it somewhere. And after realizing that, we went to the villages. Our entrepreneurs, they are enjoying themselves there. And the Premier is clear. When you go to Pitidi Sulejang,
yes.
When you go to Chaneng, when you go to Daung, you can't bring a service provider from any other. The service provider must be from that village, or that township, or that small town. So we are trying to, like I talk of balancing. We are trying to balance, to say people don't have to migrate from the village. You know, we were in one village in Muridili. Premier and his escort were eating a loaf of bread made by the women in that particular village. We were tourists, by the way. It was our short left into that village. We ate a loaf of bread without butter, and we finished that loaf. It was so nice, made by the women of the village. This is what we are saying. It's just that people, instead of them taking a look and interpreting these concrete correctly, they interpreted them wrong. They need to understand, what is it that we mean? They take them at face value. They need to get deeper into them and understand, what is this thing that they are bringing before us? How can it change the life of our people at the end of the day?
Kutla kutu kona le tulo barake mancha.
Yeah.
Mancha, one resident has been complaining that we have never seen this development that the MECs and the premiers are talking about. What do you say to Re Mujapili, who stays in Mancha?
Rome was never built in one day, Rumpo. And Premier, when he opened, he spoke of, we are dealing with the legacy of many, many years. The problem with us as politicians, I need to start with us. The problem with us politicians, we don't give feedback. You must be able to go to the people as politicians to say, as government, for this financial year, this is what we have. And we think with what we have, we are going to go to Mutoseng, go to what, and come to Manja in the next financial year. Now, that is the first mistake that we do as politicians. Okay. But also the mistake that our community sometimes do, ke go fela pelo. How le motho o fela pelo? Ba re o tshwana le ntlu. Ha e batla it's praying. So we are saying to our community, the turnaround that we have made at the Northwest Province of ensuring that we start with our villages, I believe and I'm sure of it that we will definitely touch the life of the people of Manja. What should happen? By the way, Mpho, we don't work as an island, as a province. We have local municipality. We've got CDWs. We have a lot of people on the ground that must feed us, because the Premier sitting here, myself sitting here, MEC sitting here, we will never know what is happening in our villages unless these soldiers that we have put on the ground must come up and say there is a problem here and government must come in.
Premier, Remo Japil. Ramujapili does not work. He's in Manja and is a young person.
talk to employment then?
Remember, we have just said, Mpho, that we are going for the first time in the history of this province to develop village development plans.
Yeah.
By the end of June, every village, not only Manja, they will be knowing the details of the plan and they are going to participate in the development and the adoption of the plan because we are an ANC people-centered government. At the center of what we do is the masses of our people. So that's one. Secondly, we have announced last year in the State of the Province address that we are establishing in the Premier's office YES, Youth Entrepreneurship Services. We have already appointed a director there. He's busy. The bill is going to be passed by the legislature within March. We have allocated from the Premier's office over 10 million rand, working with the IDC, working with the DBSA, working with Finance, Economy and Enterprise Development, working with the private sector here in the province. We are looking at putting at the disposal of the YES over 500 million rand, which is going to be helping our young people. We have signed an agreement with the South African National Defense Force in November, working together with the University of Bokoni Bophirima. The minister was here. We signed an agreement that the food that is consumed in the military bases in the province, they spend about a billion rand on an annual basis. That food is going to be produced by youth, working through the YES, Youth Entrepreneurship Services, and working with the Department of Rural Environment and Agricultural Development. So that agreement has already been signed. On Friday, this coming Friday, we are launching in Matlosana in Klerksdorp an institute which is going to be dealing with the challenges of skills development in as far as young people are concerned, and we are targeting over 500 young people. So we'll be signing it. We're going to be launching it on Friday in Matlosana.
Okay.
The directorate that is dealing with youth entrepreneurship services in the Premier office as part of the Sitsukuzane program has already gone to all the 19 municipalities and the 4 districts in the province to make sure that young people who are not employed, who have done their studies, are part of the YES database. We did not end there. We have pronounced and we have implemented what we call Ikatisong program for skills development. We have also announced and are implementing what is called Khetsiatsie Bursary Scheme and Skills Development Fund,
okay,
where the private sector, the government, the masses of our people, badira mokolokotwa, to make sure that we can help our young people in developing their skills.
Premier, hold it there. I want us to take a quick break. When we return, I know that there's a lot of money that has been put aside to develop Mahikeng Airport and other airports such as the Pilanesberg. And you are saying you want guests from China and India in the main
BRICS countries.
Or the BRICS countries,
yeah,
to rather not land at other airports when they come to weddings,
yeah,
in Bokoni Bophirima.
Yeah.
Okay. We're taking a quick break. When we return, we continue our conversation with the Premier of Bokoni Bophirima.
Romantic adventure film starring Ivan Buerta and Donnelly Roberts. The story begins in the beautiful vineyards of Paarl in the Western Cape. The adventure takes off when the characters find themselves on the tropical island of love, Mauritius.
Josephine's work is more interesting and distinguishable. She visits war-stricken zone countries to tell the story of the damage war often leaves behind.
This particular exhibition's case, places that are named after conflict or disaster or war or reconciliation.
And basically what it is it's a collection of the best animated short films from around the world this year. And the idea is to inspire animators and directors with this exciting content. And so that's been offered to us as a cinema, and we're very excited to be screening the animated show of shows here in South Africa.
Join Rufulo Mula for that 1 hour weekly dose of arts and entertainment news every Friday at 9 p.m. on Trends.
Mlemo, when pregnant with her first daughter, Relebogile knew that she wanted her daughter not to experience any identity issues. This is when she decided to look for toys that resembled black as beautiful.
I think for me, it was also just to get our girls to have some sense of identity, some sense of belonging.
I grew up having black and white dolls, and going to a multiracial school, I did not really see color. So for me, it's this thing of, she should actually know what her true identity is.
Join your host, Buleng Mulebatse, on Bophelong every Friday at 17:30.
The big news is Newsroom.
We also stream live on YouTube.
Whether you're at home, at the office, or the gym, wherever you are, Newsroom is right there with you. Bringing you all the latest news, updates, sports, weather, and everything in between. Get all the latest news you need on the go via live streaming on our YouTube channel. That's Newsroom, weekdays at 9 a.m. only on the SABC News Channel.
SABC News. We report, contextualize, and present news and current affairs honestly, fairly, and fully. We consider it a duty to provide consistent, relevant, useful, and top-quality information and analysis. Our mission is to provide credible, accurate, and interesting news programming, bringing news into everyone's homes in everyone's languages. Thank you, South Africa, for relying on SABC News for quality news output and for making us your number one source of information. SABC News, Africa's news leader.
Welcome back to this special broadcast from Mahikeng, right here in Bokoni Bophirima. And my name is Mpho Tsedu. I'm standing in for Pitandoro. Today with me is the premier of Bokoni Bophirima, Re Supra Mahumapelo. And we also have the MEC of Finance and the MEC of Tourism. We're talking about a lot of things, the state of this province. Premier, there was a quick question that I just received. Somebody saying a village called Mabule, outside Mahikeng, there's no fence, and animals go astray, and they are causing a lot of accidents. Some reassurance for this?
Yeah, just before I go to Mabule, before we went to the break, I wanted to say that we were the only province in this country without flights into the province.
Yes.
As we speak, there are flights from Cape Town direct to Pilanesberg, next to Sun City. Those flights are always full. You will not get a seat now if you want to book for July. And before, there was no route. Now, we speak of the boost of the economy and making sure that we increase our tourism frequency in as far as the visitors are concerned. We also have flights now from Johannesburg to the capital city, the city of Goodwill, Mahikeng. So we've got those flights. And as you were saying, we'll talk later about the big BRICS countries and how we promote weddings and so on. Now, about Mabule, I've just said that through two programs, the first one is Tsukutsai. We go to all the villages in the province. We have discussed with our traditional leaders the challenge of the government putting fences along the routes to make sure that the animals do not come onto the roads and cause accidents, but also that people must not lose their They are animals. Kantla gore khomo ke modimong ko emetsi wa nana yo wa tlhoka boroko wa tlhoka wa tlhoka boroko. So there's an agreement between us and the traditional leaders that they will get some volunteer young people who will together working with rural development, rural environment and greater development department work as rangers to make sure that those animals do not come onto the roads, because when we put fences, people steal them. You put a fence after a month, it's gone again. So the best thing that we'll have to do is to engage the local communities so that they can take care of their animals. But the MEC for Rural Environment and Agricultural Development will be announcing in her budget speech how we intend engaging with the traditional leaders and people in the rural areas to make sure that we take our livestock to the rural villages' feedlots, so that our animals no longer roam in the villages. The details will be pronounced by the MEC for Agriculture.
Now, MEC, tomorrow you're presenting your budget, right? But I want to quote you an extract here from the Premier's speech. He said, health facility improvement and maintenance will be utilized to propel VTSD economic development. Menial and small jobs such as plumbing, painting, perimeter upkeep, small electrical repairs, as well as cleaning will be done in collaboration with local entrepreneurs and cooperatives. Mm-hmm. Just expand on that.
Yeah. Mpho, what we are saying is, again, with VTSD, we are saying the work that can be done by entrepreneurs must be done by entrepreneurs. We are saying maintenance, we are saying through economy and enterprise development, we are in the process of setting up cooperatives. But these cooperatives must be set up in line with the services that we need as government to ensure that there's sustainability. Yeah. Often there is the complaint that cooperatives are set up, but we don't have work. We're saying these cooperatives must be set up so that we link them to the services and the goods that we use.
Okay.
So that is an example of what we are saying. Hospitals need maintenance, schools need maintenance, and not only maintenance, but you also need various other services. You need, these institutions would need chemicals, it would need all kinds of cleaning equipment and so on.
Okay.
We are saying, so cooperatives need to be set up within, you know, so that we can sustain them and that we can link them to the goods and services that are used by government. We are saying the same thing for municipalities. Let's get teams into place that can do maintenance, your general maintenance. And so at the same time, the very skills development that Premier has been speaking about, these young people will be trained, whether they are plumbers, whether they are boilermakers, whether they are fitters and turners, they will be trained in these type of services that we need as government, but they will then be set up as cooperatives.
Okay.
We are in the process of that. Quite a few cooperatives have been set up. I think I need to speak about one of the other things. We have also spoken about going the alternative building route, in order for it to become cheaper, in order to stretch the rand. Currently, we have cooperatives in training at a factory that has been set up in Rustenburg area. And we have these cooperatives, we have women cooperatives that are training. So when housing, local government and housing, as houses that needs to be built, we will have these cooperatives ready that will be able to go the low-cost route. Besides just building the houses, you would have out of that factory those who are doing the panels.
Mm.
You will have those who are doing window frames and door frames. You would have those who are doing plumbing and so on. You'd have those who are the carpenters. So we are saying, let's link to our goods and services that we need. Let us link these cooperatives and let our people be trained in the skills that we need so that it can become sustainable.
Premier.
Yes, sir.
Let's talk about weddings at Sun City.
Yes.
You You seem to want to encourage people to have their weddings at Sun City.
Yeah.
And you're saying you even have airports.
Yeah.
So there's no need for people to land in Gauteng.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there a particular wedding that you are referring to here?
We you know, as part of promoting tourism and talking simple economics, we have adopted Arieng Bokoni Bophirima, let us go to Northwest campaign as part of tourism. In the villages, the townships, and the small dorpies, we'll be talking to our people to give us dates and processes of their weddings so that we can also put them on the website. If you are from Australia and you want to see how, as the Botswana, we manage all the entire processes that culminate into a wedding, you can be part of that. That is at a lower level. At a higher level, you've got prestige institutions and tourism destinations like Sun City, where you have, for the first time in the history of Sun City, you had one of the biggest prestigious weddings there, organized by the Gupta family.
Yeah.
Now, I was saying to people, from an entrepreneurship point of view, from a tourism point of view, and as I said earlier on, when other people see a forest, you must see trees. I see an opportunity for us in South Africa to be the only venue that can host weddings of such a nature, where people who are billionaires, who are millionaires, instead of choosing Cape Town, Durban, and so on, they can come to Bokoni Bophirima, to Sun City. And where is the evidence? The evidence is with the Gupta family. Now, we have written a letter to the Gupta family and said to them, will you consider giving our government the DVDs of that wedding, so that when we say to people, we can host weddings of such a nature, if we go to India as part of BRICS and say we can host such weddings, they are going to say, where's the evidence?
Okay.
So we must show them the evidence. The taste of the pudding is in the eating. I don't want us to go with the brouhaha. What I want us to focus on is the opportunity that exists within that wedding that took place there. It's a reality. It took place. It's a wealthy family. So all other wealthy families within the BRICS countries, in particular India, will want them to come to Lost City in Sun City.
Okay.
Can I also come here?
Yeah. The
Thank you. You also asked the Premier, why do we want people to land straight in Pilanesberg and not go to OR?
Yes.
A week or so ago, I challenged Stat SA that myself, as the MEC of tourism, I'm not convinced of the statistics that say these are the arrivals that have come to the Northwest. What happened when people arrive in OR, they go through passport control, and the statistics that are there is that these people are in Johannesburg or they are transiting to Cape Town or whatever. When they drive from Gauteng to the Northwest, nobody track that movement. As a result, Northwest is always underestimated in terms of the arrival. I then said to State SA, I'm convinced that as the Northwest province, we are underestimated and the counting thereof is not a correct way. Now, when they land at Pilanesberg, it simply says they have arrived in the Northwest. You get my point? It's not only that the Premier don't want people to go to Gauteng. No, we are underestimated as a province on the arrivals that we get within the Northwest province.
Okay. Yeah, I think you've answered the Gupta matter.
Yes, we hope that they don't turn down our request. We hope that they can cooperate, because we don't want to be part of the noise. The reality is that there's a business opportunity there that we must pursue.
And actually, perhaps let's just wrap it up. You had referred also to other investments which that particular family had made in the province.
Which family?
The
same family, the Gupta family.
Yeah. Well, yes. It's the last question, I promise you, on the Guptas. Yes.
No, it's a reality. Look, I don't care what people say about the Gupta family. We're just looking at the facts. What are the facts? Mm. One of the facts undeniable about our province is that the Gupta family have invested in a mine. They are mining uranium in Tlaxo. They are creating jobs, therefore our people. They are increasing the economy of Bukonibu Pirima and so on. And we have not had any problems with them. Like many other families that have invested in the province here, they have heavy mines, Mosin, Lonmin, and many other mines that we have in the province. So why we are attached to this particular family, I really don't know. Because there are many other individuals and families that are investing here in the province. And we are saying to them, they must invest more in this province. They must bring their investors here in the province because they are a willing family to invest here in South Africa and in particular here in the province of Bukonibu Pirima. And I must remind South Africans that our struggle in South Africa is for the liberation of blacks in general and Africans in particular. Mm-hmm. And South Africa belongs to all who live in black and white. Now you can't isolate an Indian family because that contradicts what we say in the Constitution of the Republic, in the Freedom Charter, and in the strategy and tactics document of the ANC. They constitute, as an Indian family, part of the black majority here in South Africa. And as I said, we pursue a struggle that seeks to advance the economy to benefit blacks in general and Africans in particular. And with our white compatriots, some work, some track. We must pull together to build one united, diversified South Africa.
We are going to take a break. When we return, we'll be going to our tables to take questions. Those of you who have sent us the questions, indeed, just prepare yourself to pose those questions to our esteemed panel here. This is the SABC TNA Business Brief. We shall return shortly.
Victory requires intense effort and teamwork. When you get to it, there is no turning back because all eyes are on you. When it's action time, nothing should stand in your way. Sports Life tackles and analyzes all the sport action. This is the home of all your sport news, updates, and more. Sports Life weekdays at 8:30 p.m.
Get all the latest news from the SABC's online news services on our website. Breaking news and in-depth coverage of everything from business, sports, to politics and lifestyle. Catch the top news clips and watch live streaming of major news events on the SABC News YouTube channel whenever. Stay connected on the SABC News Facebook page and have your say on news that matters to you. And for the latest headlines and live updates from our reporters, follow us on Twitter. SABC Digital News, anytime, anywhere.
Welcome back, Ralo Amogela gape go ka tlhamalo go tswa ko bokone bophirima Mahikeng ke ditshano ha le tona kholo re Supra Mahumapelo le two of the members of the executive council of the province, and we are just unpacking the state of the province but also just clarifying some of the issues that may have emerged out of that particular state of the province address. And right now we're going to our tables to just take a few questions which you have. Let me start table one. There's Rekhumalo Molefe. He is a PEC member of SANCO. PEC is the Provincial Executive Committee. Re Molefe, if you've got a microphone, let me just ask that we get a microphone straight to you. Re Molefe is standing there to pose his question. Thank you very much. Just be brief.
Thank you very much, and good morning to the Premier and members. That we are encouraged by progress made by the fifth administration. Of course, inevitably, it's not without flaws. We acknowledge them. Our question is, Premier, as part of cost cutting, how does your administration plan to cap overpricing, particularly on capital projects such as tenders? And how do we ensure that the road made today is not eroded 6 months down the line? We're talking quality assurance versus return on investment. Thank you.
Premier.
Well, thanks for the question, Ndade Khumalo. Finance, economy, and enterprise development have been given a mandate to make sure that we scrutinize the pricing very closely, and that where there are problems, finance, economy, and enterprise development will have to intervene, because it's indeed true that there are some people who overprice, because it is the state which is going to be involved in those transactions. But secondly, the issue of quality. We are going to be partnering with the private sector, including the University of the Northwest, working with the Department of Public Works and Roads here in the province. Some of the mines have also said they'll give us some of their engineers to make sure that we collaborate, some work, some track, in making sure that there's quality assurance. It means from the beginning of the project, throughout the project, until the project is now certified. At the end of the project, there will be that continuous assessment. But from the Premier's office also, we have just strengthened our performance monitoring evaluation, and we have inserted a T. We have inserted a T there, which is I actually, not T, intervention, to make sure that you don't just do performance monitoring and evaluation. Where there is a problem, you must intervene as the Premier's office and provide decisive leadership. So the team from the Premier's office will also be accompanying those who will be assessing the projects on the ground.
Okay, thank you very much, Premier. Let's go to our second question now. Go tswa go khosi mogakolodi masibi go tswa kontlong ya makhosi o go tswa ntlong ya dikhosi ya bokone bophirima table 2 re go tswa khosi masibi mogakolodi masibi table 2 khosi kgolo o emeletse fale, if you could just get a microphone through to him, and there we go.
Thank you, Mpho. Morning, Honorable Premier and MECs. My question is based on the long outstanding traditional courts bill, whereby more than 2 million rural dwellers in the province are denied justice. I just wanted to find out from the Premier, how far will the court be enacted to enact so that our people in rural areas should gain access to justice?
Yes, go ahead.
We discussed that yesterday, and our intention is to finalize it by the next quarter of this year.
Is that the answer?
Yes, that's the answer. We talked about it yesterday. Wow. So it's on track, Khosi Masibi. Our intention is to make sure that we finalize it by the by the next quarter. It's not only this matter. Now that our traditional leaders are here, we are also dealing with the disputes, long outstanding disputes, a package of them within the areas of the traditional authorities. And we are pushing them. So far, we have processed over 80% of the disputes. And I hope our traditional leaders can appreciate that we are making some progress. And I must say, Khosi Masivi, the deputy chair was with us and the chairperson of the province when we were focusing on processing some of the disputes 2 weeks ago.
Okay. Yeah, that's, you know, a little bit longer as opposed to the summary that you gave. I know it may have been concise and to the point. Added some more meat there. Table 3, itumeleng shole, ke khosana go tsoka batlung ba ga shole. Table number 3, let's get a microphone there. Itumeleng, a kitso gore a me wa bonwa. Okay, if you could just get a microphone through to table 3 for us there. Meanwhile, right there at home, you can participate through making sure that you join our hashtag and you will be able to participate there. Let me allow you to pose your question there.
What practical strategy does government have to ensure that the proposed expropriation bill is actually beneficial to the people, considering the current shortfall of the restitution bill and then also restitution act and also the skills, because ga go thusi sepe o naya re Solomon o tswang ko pitsidishule jang o mona pene mme a sa itse go kwala. So re batla go itse what practical strategy does government have in place to ensure gore so suicide re ke leboga.
Okay, thank you very much. And may I just apologize, I've been mixing up table numbers here. I didn't see, that was table 19 as opposed to 3 as I had said, and my apologies in that regard. Premier?
The Department of Rural Environment and Agricultural Development, working with the National Department, but also working with Finance, Economy and Enterprise Development, we've agreed that as we give back people their land, they must make sure that they, at the center of everything that we do, must be to sit down with such families, such individuals, and agree well in advance on a process that is going to make sure that they use the land much more productively. I'll make you an example. We have pronounced in the State of the Province address that there's a 9 items bowel to deal with poverty, from porridge up to meat up to cooking oil. It's 9 items, which we said they constitute a basket that we need to attend to in making sure that our people are not hungry. Now that basket, you can only deal with it successfully if you use the land effectively. That's why rural environment and agricultural development have been mandated to make sure that every piece of land becomes productive. But our people must also remember that we face a challenge of drought, which is not in our control. Yeah. So we have said to the department that they must work with our communities to look at alternative methods of doing scientific agriculture.
Okay.
So that as part of boosting our economy, we can use other methods, which I think our people will embrace going forward.
Premier, you know, I'm happy that you touched on this question that has got to do with rural development and all that. There's something, I don't want to say it's controversial. Perhaps it's controversial in South Africa.
Yeah.
You have come out to say that the province is going to be breeding donkeys because Namaya donkey atlogera in other countries.
Yes. Last year, during the China Week, as part of making sure that we bring as many investors as possible to the People's Province of Bokone Bophirima, we had an engagement with the Chinese government and the business people from China. So one of the discussions we had, which they raised, was the possibility of us supplying them with donkey meat. And about 2 weeks ago, we had the Department of Rural Environment and Agricultural Development, they went to Sanisof to deal with microeconomic development challenges in that particular area. And we met an investor there who said, already they have an offtake with some people in China where they are going to be exporting donkey meat. From the government side, our agreement with the Chinese is that we must be working on the details of the agreement. Remember, there are minimum standards that we have to adhere to, which relate to hygiene and many other things like packaging and so on. The breeding facilities need to meet certain standards. So we are working with the Chinese on that. We sent a team to Botswana because Botswana had attempted donkey meat export to the People's Republic of China. We have shared some valuable lessons with them. So as soon as a breakthrough has been made, we are going to be announcing to our people how they are going to be doing the breeding, what quantities do they need in China of donkey meat, and how government is going to be working with them to make sure that we adhere to the minimum standards in as far as health matters are concerned. But it's a huge demand that is there. For our people, it's a big entrepreneurship opportunity.
Yeah, SLA.
SLA, right. Mungwa yonawa ebaad.
Okay. MEC, I want us to take a quick break. When we return, okay, I'll give you an opportunity to just respond to that. We're coming to you live from Bukonubupiri Makuma Hikengle, Tonakolo Supra Mahumapelo. We're taking a quick break. When we return, we'll continue with our discussion. Please don't go away.
Good afternoon, you're watching the Midday Report.
Lunchtime news amplified.
But for now, this is what they call home. Their hope to shift to higher ground seems to be against the tide.
Midday Report provides you with more than just news stories.
I just want Port Elizabeth to know that they own a world-class theater.
Good afternoon, you're with the news at one in the headlines.
Very good afternoon to you. This is News Live. I'm Natasha Thorpe. Let's take a quick look at what's coming up in your headlines.
Good afternoon and welcome to A View from the House.
For all things news, tune in to Midday Report weekdays at 12 noon only on the SABC News Channel.
As stories are broken around the world, SABC makes sure you do not miss out. As the stories unfold throughout the day, News at 8 updates all newsworthy stories worldwide. Globally, we are there. Locally, we leave no story untold. Make a date with News at 8 every Saturday and Sunday on SABC News, Africa's news leader.
Contralesa is actually stirring the pot here.
I'm sure they've been consulted as Contralesa. They did not see a snake. Now that in certain areas there are certain benefits that might possibly be accruing, there is a snake, now we need to reverse the process.
I agree, but it is not above the sovereignty of the people. The very same court you're talking about.
The sovereignty of the people, probably you should explain that to me. But
the sovereignty of the people is above everything.
It is not proper the way facts are presented to the public. Are you in contact with Khosekhulu Mutshudi?
He was kicked out by the court because he wanted to be amicus curiae.
For your weekly dose of all things legal, join Dumile Mateza every Sunday at 2 p.m. only on SABC News Channel.
Welcome back, everybody. I hope you're enjoying the new age SABC business briefing that we've got coming your way, coming from the Northwest Province. Let's read some of the tweets that we've been receiving this morning, and perhaps Mpho can actually ask those questions to the Premier and some of the MECs. Here's the very first one that's come through, and it's from Mpho Mathomela saying, I beg to differ. In Sipaye, near Borakalalo Game Reserve, there is a bridge that gets full when it rains. What is being done about that? All right, there's a big question for you. Romeo saying, can the Premier please tell us how he is going to deal with procurement irregularities in municipalities? Right? Another question coming in from some of our viewers. And here's another one that we've got from somebody. Good morning, Premier. I would like to ask about the progress of YES, or YES, as I applied for funds last year. All right. It's probably a fund that maybe the Premier can talk a little bit more about that. So there's three questions for you. Perhaps you can answer those ones. There's apparently another question coming in. Let's just put these up on the screen now. Tsedu, what is the Premier's plan regarding the situation in the Northwest Mahikeng campus, which is a very, very important issue to touch on. Here's another one. We must be honest with our people. Where we've made mistakes, we must own up equally as we speak about progress. Karis Mochane writing in. BB is rising again and will go higher. It will be anything necessary to take its rightful place among the provinces of South Africa. Some comments coming from viewers as well as some questions. And Paul, I throw it back to you. And hopefully the Premier and his MECs can answer and address some of those questions.
Okay, unfortunately, we couldn't hear my colleague Lian from Auckland Park there. Technological issues here. However, we'll rather settle for what is a guarantee. We're going to table number one. Ponso Hosieng, you are an RTT coordinator, Dr. RSM. Your question, please.
Thanks very much, Premier and MEC, particularly of tourism. In the quest for REM Bugweni Bupirima, my question is, when is the Tau skull coming to Tau? Thanks very much.
Ah, let me see, a very good question there. The Tau skull is not in Tau.
It's true. But I think it's very important that we should educate our people also. The Tau skull belongs to REAP, but because it's government, I will answer the question. MEC Mankete Kape is the one responsible for ensuring that the Taung skull is coming back home together with us as the ESCO. But what the department is doing right now, they are busy with renovation because we want that to be a tourism attraction area once it's completed. They can't just take it from Johannesburg and bring it here and we don't know where to put for the tourists to come and see. But the MEC is busy with the development in the area at Buxton where the skull must go. And we are clear, Mukoni, we don't want a replica. We want the real skull.
Let me see. I had cut you short there. You wanted to add something on
on the donkey enterprise.
Yes. Oh, is it called Donkey Enterprise?
Well, it's an opportunity.
Okay.
It's an opportunity, Mpho. Premier was talking about the donkey meat. I thought it just necessary to indicate that currently tests are being done on the donkey hide. So it would be the whole value chain, not only donkey meat that they are interested in, but the donkey skin as well, the donkey hide. So it would be the value chain. And that, therefore, is a great opportunity. It may not be, you know, we may not eat donkey, we may not eat donkey, use donkey skin, but someone else is out there, and that is an opportunity for us. So it would be the full value chain that we're looking at.
Okay, let's quickly rush to table number two. Rantwa Paul Dlamini. This is very important. This is a very important sector. Let's get a question there.
My question, there is a lot of crime that is happening in our province, especially in Corona. The second question,
Muruti.
Premier, calm down and explain the rights of the bana because bana ba misuse the rights of the bana.
Okay.
We have a program as part of the five concretes called reconciliation, healing and renewal. Now, as part of reconciliation, healing and renewal, we have embarked on a program of ensuring that our people partner with the police. We partner with all law enforcement agencies to make sure that there is no crime on the ground. I must say to our people, we cannot have a police person in every house. Mpho, we can't have a police person in every bedroom because we don't know what is happening in the bedroom. We are asking our people to make sure that person-to-person relations are improved. Make sure that when I have a difference with you, we engage and engage and engage to resolve the problem. If it's a dispute in the family, let's sit as a family. If it's a dispute in the village, let's sit as a village. Let's sit with the traditional leaders, with organizations on the ground in the village, so that we can resolve our matters amicably. Let's sit with the churches, so that those who have got emotional and psychological problems and so on can be attended to a bit differently, because some people are just too angry. And I think a bit of counseling, a bit of involving the church and so on might help them with subsiding the anger, because the anger can really lead you into doing some things you never intended to do.
Talking about social cohesion, I mean, a month or so ago at Ramatlabama, there was a tragedy there. Government made some commitments to assist. Let's just talk about
that. Yes, the Department of Social Development has already gone there. And we were also part of the activities that took place there. It's not only in Ramatlabama. You know, during the weekends, Saturdays and Sundays, other people do overconsumption of lubricants, like alcohol. And when they do this overconsumption, it then takes over. It now leads them into things that they are not supposed to be doing. Now, we are going to urge our tavern owners and shebeens and so on to work with the police so that as people entertain themselves and they consume, we must try and monitor such people so that as you observe them, we can help them. Others get involved in accidents. So we must find a way of helping them, because if we don't do that, there's going to be trouble. So we urge our people, you must not, after getting drunk, you begin to assault your wife, you assault your husband, and you terrorize your children.
Okay. Let's go to table number 13, Duduzi Moyo, Mpilo Royal College. You're the chief executive officer there. I think you want to do some lobbying here. Duduzi? I'm not so sure if it is
good
on.
Morning,
just,
sir.
We'll just make sure. Yes, it is on.
Thank you very much, Mpho. Good morning, Premier and MECs. Premier, we all know that the health sector is critical in supporting economic growth. Premier, may you please afford Mpilo Royal College an opportunity to partner with Northwest Provincial Department of Health to advance NHI, National Health Strategy, and also primary healthcare re-engineering through training of nurses under new regulation and health promotion officers. Thank you.
Well, like I said, you wanted to do some lobbying.
Yeah, no, remember we have announced that one of our concretes is some work, some track to work with everybody. So the MEC for health is here. I'm sure if he's given the mic, he can elaborate on what is it that the Department of Health can do and will do.
Okay.
Exactly, with such partnerships. If you can just give the MEC for health the mic, so that because we work with everybody,
okay,
in the province.
MEC, an instruction has come out.
Thank you very much, Mpho. What would want you to work with us to apply and follow the right procedure. We need nurses in this country. We need nurses in this province, and we'll be glad to work with you. Thank you very much.
Mr. Moyo, you've got your answer there. I'm sure you saw he's on table number 3. So if you miss this opportunity, You may have to wait for next year. Table number 19, Natasha Loeto Sising, top six candidate, SABC One Day leader in South Africa. Natasha? Table number 19. Let's get Natasha the microphone. Let's see.
Good morning, Premier and the MECs. The question that I have is, as a young person, the Premier's vision is to see the Northwest Province being the second largest economy by 2030. And I want to ask, what is being done, especially for young people? We know that we have, yes, the youth entrepreneurship services, but in terms of innovation, to ensure that we are competitors also on global markets, and also equipping young people with business education to ensure that this is a plan that is both sustainable and realistic in the Northwest context.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm going to request responses from all of you actually on this one. Premier, let me start with you.
We have an agreement. We have signed a memorandum of agreement with the University of the Northwest. In as far as issues of innovation is concerned, CSIR has also agreed to be working with us. We want to target the youth through youth entrepreneurship services. So you are welcome, my sister, to work with us to make sure that we advance that objective. Because without innovation and without support to the ideas that are propelled by young people to change our economy, will not go anywhere.
Let me see.
Thanks, Mpho. I think one of the important things is also to indicate that we're looking at enterprise development centers. We've already started rolling them out. As indicated, we have young people who have ideas. They don't know where to take these ideas to. They don't know how to set up business plans. So these enterprise development centers would then be a gateway for them, which where they would be assisted with their business plans, with their feasibility studies, and also funding opportunities. So these enterprise development centers are extensions of economy and enterprise development.
Okay, let me see.
Thank you, Mpho. I think South Africa should know that as the Department of Tourism, we are supporting Natasha and we are marketing her very well to ensure that she made it in this program of SABC 2.
So she was paid to get here.
Some work, some track.
Okay. And maybe we must just take this opportunity, you know, to congratulate Wenam Fifi Cooper.
Yes.
A young person coming from the city of Goodwill in Mahikeng. She has won the Metro Awards last week. So congratulations to her.
Mpho, as the department, we are working closely with the youth. It's not only Fifi, we also have got Kaspar Nyoves, our shining stars of the North, so they've made it in the Metro Award. What we are also saying at the Department of Tourism, the program of the Premier of going to our villages, township and small dorpies, we want each and every village, out of the 767 villages, we want a youth who will come and say, Kodinukana, this is the history of Dinukana. As I told you, this is what you can enjoy from Dinukana. And through our Makota, we are challenging youth to attend our Makota so that we can share ideas. But all what we are saying as tourism, we must build our youth to continue to carry the history of the Batswana and pride themselves with what the Batswana are doing. You could see what happened during the State of the Province address. The Premier Unabukwa keep a little princess. So Barona serious. We continually have. You have Mutwako first. People think Mutwako first is from heaven. It comes from here.
Okay. You're bragging there. All right. We're going to take a quick break. When we return, we wrap up our questions and today's program. We're coming to you live from Bukoni Pirima Ko Mahikeng.
the queen of the pop and lock, and whatever this is, the party train conductor, all aboard. The answer is yes, you are that guy, and we salute you, party comrade. Join the movement online.
A romantic adventure film starring Ivan Buerta and Donnelly Roberts. The story begins in the beautiful vineyards of Paarl in the Western Cape. The adventure takes off when the characters find themselves on the tropical island of love, Mauritius.
Josephine's work is more interesting and distinguishable. She visits war-stricken zone countries to tell the story of the damage war often leaves behind.
This particular exhibition's case, places that are named after conflict or disaster or war or reconciliation.
And basically what it is it's a collection of the best animated short films from around the world this year. And the idea is to inspire animators and directors with this exciting content. And so that's been offered to us as a cinema, and we're very excited to be screening the animated show of shows here in South Africa.
Join Rufulo Mula for that 1 hour weekly dose of arts and entertainment news every Friday at 9 p.m. on Trends.
The big news is Newsroom.
We also stream live on YouTube.
Whether you're at home, at the office, or at the gym, wherever you are, Newsroom is right there with you, bringing you all the latest news, updates, sports, weather, and everything in between. Get all the latest news you need on the go via live streaming on our YouTube channel. That's Newsroom, weekdays at 9 a.m., only on the SABC News Channel.
Technology isn't all scary. There's also fun stuff like gaming.
Lots of women do play games, whether it's on their phones or their tablets.
Then there are Africans who are using new tools to make other people's lives much easier.
We typed the whole CV on a small QWERTY Nokia phone.
For all these and other technology and social media news, join me, Sphumelele Zondi, every Sunday at 7:30 p.m. Central African Time on SABC News.
Welcome back. Like I said, we're coming to you live from Bokonebophirima with the Premier and MECs here at at Mahikeng. Premier, we have unfortunately ran out of time, but I want to just give you closing remarks. I had wanted to talk about Marikana, the housing project, that is. Perhaps you can just include that in your closing.
The housing project in Marikana is going very well. It's one of the best houses we have ever built here in South Africa and in the province. We urge the people of Marikana to cooperate with the municipality in occupying those particular houses. But I just want to say to our people here in the province and our South Africans that it's important for us to make sure that at all times we pull together. We must make sure that we build the image of South Africa to become the best image, something that the world can look up to.
We saw at the university.
Not what we saw at the university, because that was terrible. And we are very happy that the university reported to us that they are taking drastic measures against the individuals who touched the buildings at the university. We want to say to our people of Bokonebophirima, our economy is constrained. We are operating under very difficult economic conditions. We have adopted an approach of biki-biki, mark-mere economic system. We want to spread whatever little resources that we have across the province. We hope that our people can understand. But the culture of hard work must accompany everything that we do. Because if you don't sweat, you are not going to be getting what you intend to get as a person in life.
Okay. Let me thank you. MEC, I know you've got your budget speech tomorrow. We wish you all the best. We hope that you will have those billions of rands to ensure that service delivery goes to our people out there.
MEC,
also thank you for having made time. And let's hope that indeed guests will fly in to the province directly.
Indeed.
Indeed, indeed, Mpho.
Okay, thank you very much. Don't forget that right there at home, we'll be going to the province of KwaZulu-Natal next, and that will be on the 9th with MEC Mabuyakulu. That will be the TNA SABC breakfast. And for me, here in Mahikeng, Retlotse Kholekane, Apulayene.
All right, Mpho, thank you very, very much for putting the broadcast out there for us this morning. Direct flights being proposed, well, not proposed, promoted here. So fly directly to the Northwest, as you heard Mpho punting there on the program. Have a wonderful day, everyone. We'll see you again tomorrow morning, bright and early, 6 o'clock. Take care until then and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye, everyone.